with that. All right, let's go. New staff, come on down here, man. New staff.
First impressions are key. Every year, a new group of staff members are introduced in front of the team.
I'm Coach William Inge. I work with the linebackers.
I'm the Rare Sims. I'm the running backs coach. I'm from Union, South Carolina.
This is the first opportunity to meet the guys. Man, impress with your moves. You join a team because you think you can make them better. That's exactly why Darrell Sims and William Inge are here.
All right, hey man. Hey, so you're gonna face this way. Face this way, under, bend. Knee bend, under and over. Under, there we go. No, you're good. Everything we do, we will always start off the day with something excellent.
For new coaches, it's important to earn the trust of your guys. Spring is the perfect time to build that relationship.
Anything happen spectacular today for anybody? Hey, there we go. That's what I'm talking about.
What you can expect from me as a coach, high energy, being detail oriented, and pushing my guys to their limit. You know, making sure that they understand that I love and I care about them, but I want them to be the best that they can be as a person. I want them to be the best that they can be as a football player.
I can't come into the building and say, man, today I'm just gonna get through this. I get to come out here and execute number one. I get to come out here and compete with my brothers in this room, with my teammates on the field. So we gotta understand, before you can go achieve any goal, you gotta have that mentality to go do it.
I think you look at the trajectory of the program now, and then the opportunity to come into what I feel like is RBU and being able to put your imprint and your stamp on it and help this program achieve the levels that we all want to get to.
We got to do a really good job, okay, of always making sure we're competing, listening to the instructions, competing and getting after.
The hardest part is, one, just making sure the guys trust you, because, you know, they're always looking at whenever a new guy comes in there, it's like, all right, what's this guy going to be about? Is he going to be real? Is he someone I can trust? Is he someone that can help me?
Let's go, Hunter, let's go, take the field, let's go. Work my feet just like I'm going to attack the ball kid, you know what I'm saying?
Good job, Sam!
His ability to communicate, his ability to teach, and his overall football knowledge was extremely clear right from the jump.
Now we steering. Good, steer it!
We knew that was the guy we had to get in the building.
We got to do a really good job of kicking the intensity and the tempo up. It's like we running in mud right now, moving in slow motion, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, everything's happening fast, but I got to be able to play fast, the same situation in the game.
In the running back room here, you understand that the legacy that we're continuing to build on top of, the groundwork has been built tremendously. So every day when we come to work, it's no wasted movement, it's no wasted rep, it's no wasted meeting. Everything is to get 1% better, and we gotta attack that from the moment that we step into the building to the time that we get home at night.
It's the little bitty simplistic things that make us be explosive, make us be playmakers.
When the ship gets a little wavy in the sea, the captain will always bring it in and calm everybody down. Is that clear? And that's what we have to be able to do.
The biggest thing I would say is in our room, the levels of demand, the levels of accountability is also very high.
High line of accountability when it comes to what you do every day from a workout standpoint. Our speed has to be going up on a day-to-day basis. Our leadership has to be going up. Our urgency has to be there. We have to become more urgent.
He's super confident in what he believes in the right way to win. And he preaches on us every day. And he's super big on getting us out of our comfort zone.
It's your job to help someone, because at some point in time, it could be one of us in the room. And what should your teammate do? Lift you up.
The one thing that I know is this game is such a great gift. I do everything I can to make sure that the players somehow, some way, try to smile every day. Every day of practice, whether it's me making them smile somehow with a corny joke or just being able to say something just so they can see themselves smile and see each other smile, because this game can be fun. It's supposed to be fun. And that's what this great sport is all about.
Hey man, hey.
Hey man, it's a great Monday, mental Monday workout. You ready? Ready, sure? Why are you fumbling the balls, man? The pride and tradition of Tennessee football will not be entrusted to the weak, timid, or non-committed, right? Correct?
All right. So make sure we're not that. Good job. Going that way. Hey, it's going that way, baby. Hey. Hey, it's going that way. I love the energy, the passion, and the thing that would probably the most, seeing guys run into the football. Because often, more times than not, when you're running to the ball, the odds are going to favor you.
Something that we have to create in our room, it's an ever-encompassing avenue of leadership. So in order for leadership to occur, there has to be a multitude of streets that has to align. So what I like to do on our end is we let the players come do the things. Because when the players have a chance to lead, the other players see it. And it's going to give them a higher level of influence.
Something I want to make sure that we do is from coach to player, there has to be a systematic way for us to make sure we can get a great evaluation. Because in order for me to be a better coach, I kind of have to know, what are you thinking inside this big old rock head? So there's a little thought process that we have that somebody's going to go over with you step by step, because leadership is best coupled with action. So I'm going to turn the stage over to you.
Coach William Inge has to know he can trust his guys. Jeremiah Telander is looking early on to answer that call.
Obviously, I started as the third string linebacker, and our coaches preach all the time, like, you got to practice and study like you're the starter. First game, we had a dude get injured, and my role stepped up completely. And if I wouldn't have been preparing and studying like I was, I would have been in a bad situation. I was blessed to get a lot of reps last year and make some plays out there. I feel like I always just try to attack the ball no matter where it's at. At linebacker, like, you could be in a bad position, but at the end of the day, you're trying to tackle the dude with the ball. So I would say I play relentless.
Yeah, the one thing that we've seen from him is his level of preparation has definitely increased when it comes to him wanting to do more things and doing more things and also showing that as well. That's been something that from a staff we have definitely been pleased with.
It's a beautiful Saturday. Hey, it's Saturday. We holding nothing back, baby. Let's get it.
I think preparing is like the biggest thing that you can do as a linebacker. I think it's the most important. If you don't prepare as a linebacker, you're going to go out there and look lost. You're not going to know what you're doing.
As linebackers, you're the quarterbacks of defense. So you have to be able to communicate. You have to be able to speak. You have to be able to look at your teammates. You have to be able to talk with your teammates.
Yeah!
We're trying to give him some elements where he could have some tools in his pocket that he could be able to use when he's on the field.
You got to step out on the field with some type of confidence, especially at Mike linebacker. This is the biggest offseason of my life, and I take pride in that, and I just want to become the best inside linebacker that I can become. The spring ball is huge. The team looks a little different than last year, and just getting to know the new guys and seeing how they play and being able to play with each other.
New faces are all around the building this year, but the standards remain the same. That all starts with family, connection, and football.